I guess I'm used to a lot of stats in this area. $33 billion a year is apparently what cybercrime costs us. Is there any way to quantify what we pay for that deterrence? And is it skewed? Is it still nowhere near enough?
I like to talk about the iceberg economics of cybercrime, because the reality is, even when we're quantifying the cost, the harm to Australia's economy, our statistics are pretty fuzzy. For a start, not all cyber incidents that should get reported up do get reported up. We've got inconsistent mechanisms for understanding and quantifying the harm that occurs when incidents happen as well. So even just right-sizing what actually is the cost to Australia's economy is a fuzzy business. Then when it comes to thinking about what that investment is on the right of the ledger, as it were, what we need to put down to protect protect Australia's economy, that also becomes particularly hard. That's why I think the role for government, though, isn't about being the catcher that catches all of the different kind of cyber volleys that come our way. The role for government needs to be two things. One, setting standards and making sure they're enforced, so we've got a clear baseline of cybersecurity across our economy. And two, it's being that coordinator that when crises happen, not if, because when they will happen again, our government has a depoliticised, clear, coordinated approach to supporting industry and supporting itself through cyber crises.
Always a lot to unpack and always right on top of it.